Welcome back from that short break. You're still watching Innovate here on Urban TV. Now, the Consortium for Affordable Medical Technologies in Uganda, which is Camtech, has taken a leap in innovations from simple student ideas, and now they have products on the market. Sani Drop is one of them, and we met with the developers, and they talked to us.
Like its name suggests, Sani Drop is a hand sanitizer that takes just a drop to kill germs. The team want to reduce the spread of diseases that are hand transmitted.
It's a hand sanitizer called Sani Drop, meaning sun, or sun, which is from hand sanitizer, and drop, which is a drop. So you only use a drop to cleanse your hands.
Sani Drop is a brainchild of students from Camtech, together with Mbarara University of Science and Technology, inspired by the need to control spread of diseases in health centers.
This is an innovation that was done by Camtech with an intent to reduce the spread of infections from persons to persons. The intent of this is to reduce the spread right from the hospital to, if we may take an example of a hospital that is between a health worker and a patient. A patient might be contaminated, and a health worker who works on this patient comes without gloves. This person is likely to infect the patient, and the patient infect a health worker.
Its contents include alcohol, distilled water, and tea. The alcohol in it has been tested to allow Muslims to use it as well.
It's made up of alcohol as its content, distilled water. We have tea, we have glycol, vitamin E, and isopropanol. That is alcohol. It has been tested, and so it is being used across both the non-Muslim Muslims and the Christian non-Muslims. Because of the alcohol content within, it has been tested, and so it can be used by all.
The basic percentage of alcohol needed to disinfect is 70% in normal cases. So the challenge, one of the challenges we're facing, is that it has taken us some time to actually get approval from some of these bodies.
Sani Drop is tested and is being used around, awaiting approval by UNBS.
It is not on market much as it's there, but not on a large scale. Reason being, we've not been approved by UNBS, but we are in a pipeline to get registered and approved. So when once approved, we shall hit the market, because currently we are having a 50 milliliter tin at 2,000, which means we are targeting both high income earners, low income earners, because we all suffer from the same disease indiscriminately.
And the major targets are public places like hospitals, schools, and churches.
So with the use of Sani Drop, it means we are ready to curb the infection spread, and this is majorly our focus is hospitals, public places, churches, schools, and hotels, or even discotheques.
Sani Drop has a 50 milliliter bottle that goes for 2,000 shillings, but this price could change after they receive approval from the Ugandan National Bureau of Standards.
Camtech Uganda recently held a global surgery hackathon where clinicians, entrepreneurs, students and designers spent 48 hours developing innovative medical technologies to improve surgical care in resource-limited settings. This was held at the Mbarara University of Science and Technology. We'll bring you the whole event as it unfolded.
The global surgery hackathon saw many ideas developed within 48 hours, all of them health interventions meant to help in healthcare service delivery. The contraceptive implant finder seeks to encourage mothers to use this birth control method. The lead team member is a graduate from Mbarara University of Science and Technology. Also developed was MobiCare, a mobile application that links users to health workers.
MobiCare simply is a mobile application that helps users to link up with health workers. The challenge that we are trying to address here is inappropriate access to health workers for medical consultation. And so we have developed a mobile application that will make it easy for users to link up with health workers regardless of their location.
Other top prototypes included the auto thermal.
The challenge we are addressing here is irregular temperature monitoring among neonates. A neonate is a baby who is 28 days old or younger. So why we picked interest in this, it's because we realize that whenever someone is sick, temperature is the indicator of illness. So the first step they take to detect if an infection, they take someone's temperature. So what we are coming up with is a temperature band that will be communicating with a screen, and this band is an auxiliary band that will be worn on the upper arm of the child, and results from this band will be displayed in the board.
Another innovation is the automated radio program recording system, or smart radio. With it, one would be able to record a radio program and listen to it later.
This is a smart radio. It's smart in a way that this radio works automatically according to the time. It has three basic modules. That is the switching module, and the timing module, and the recording module. Combined together, that's what makes this recording system.
A non-invasive technology that monitors kidney functionality without pricking was also demonstrated by students at the hackathon.
Kidney disease over the years has been increasing in Africa and sub-Saharan region, showing the tremendous increase of this disease, and the main problem is detected at late stages. The machines to detect it are very expensive, and the charges they charge for testing this disease are as well very high. So we came up with a very simple solution by testing it using a non-invasive way, whereby it doesn't require pricking like the current measures that are being used, and it monitors the kidney functionality by obtaining a particular value that is usually obtained by the other machines while detecting the kidney disease.
Many students can come up with fantastic ideas and even develop prototypes, but the biggest challenge for them is financial support to push such into commercialization.
We need funding, and there is no innovation that can reach a final stage without funding. The funding we get at Camtech, that's what has helped us at least reach this prototyping stage. But with more funding, we believe we can reach where we want to be.
That sums up our week in tech. But of course, with technology, we bring you all the ease for you to know here on Innovate. Keep giving us your feedback on both our Facebook and Twitter pages using the hashtag UrbanInnovate, or my personal handle at Kembenda. And of course, we came to you today from the Innovation Village here in Ntinda, at the Ntinda Complex Block B Level 3, the Moonshot Factory to turn all your ideas into real-time solutions. I've been your host, Brenda Kembabazi. Have yourselves a good evening.